As you all know, you have heard it in our dispensation, you have heard from others, and you can see the changes that are occurring on your planet. And through our dispensation, you have heard that the original plan date of your beloved Earth shifting her axis, previously scheduled for May 26, 2012, that this has changed, and your beloved planet has chosen to begin shifting her axis now. And this has been going on for a number of weeks, as she feels that this is the perfect time to begin that gradual shift. Your Earth, your planet, has her own inner wisdom. She is a mighty fine being, and she is very aware and very much desires to shift her axis. Every planet in its evolution shifts its axis and does this to support a new evolution within all the kingdoms of life on Earth and to support the intelligent species that are living on that planet in their evolution. As you have heard before, your planet has delayed shifting her axis because of the discord that has been on this planet and the frightful ongoing invention of war machines that have left an imprint of war and the usage of atomic weapons that is so destructive to life on Earth. All of this has compelled your planet to delay shifting her axis because she knows that when she does this, the discord that has penetrated the gas belts, the powers of nature, the forces of the elements, the atmosphere, and the inner structure of the Earth, that discord would not allow her to shift her axis without there being catastrophic impact on the surface of the planet. You have seen, as the planet has been preparing for years to shift the axis, you have seen an alarming increase in that which are extreme patterns of weather and earthquakes, and now, as has been prophesied, we have come to a place where your planet is constantly shaking. There is never a moment now, in these days right now, that there is not an earthquake that is happening inside your planet, and your planet is trembling. What many people are not talking about is what is behind this shift in the planet's axis. It is about your planet Earth desiring to fulfill her own destiny and to assist all life that lives on her and grows from her, to assist all life and herself to shift into a higher frequency of light and love. This is the natural way of life. And so, dear hearts, these are facts that you already know. And as I explained on the Friday in Calgary, there is something that is very important for you to hear. I would say, because I have known for 3,000 years that I would make this request of you, I would say that regarding the Earth changes, aside from being a lightning rod, an instrument between the heavenly realms and your planet, where each of you can use your free will and call to the greater to bring forth the help that your planet so requires at this time, aside from that, I say to you that what I am about to reveal to you is so mighty important and has everything to do to the shift and the changes that are going to occur in yourself and the ensuring that each of you are doing what you can so that you receive the all-important powers of divine intervention that are intended to come into your lives, fulfilling our message, help is on the way. Now, dear heart, as I said in Calgary, sometimes you hear something and it is so simple, yet as it passes through your being, you have a feeling that it is absolutely profound, especially as you unite with it. And this is one of those moments. Many are talking about earth changes. There is no one who has suggested what I am about to suggest to you, because it is not their place to suggest it. As the Chohan of the dispensation of the Mother's Presence of the Rose Pink Flames to your earth, it is my authority to say to you what I am about to. I ask that each of you will allow a deep, profound increase in your awareness behind the words and the request I am asking you. This is so important, and before you receive the blessing that comes to you from the great central sun, it is so important, dear heart, that this already be in place. Therefore, I say to you, in all future classes, until the passage of the Radiant Rose Conclave in Edmonton, I will use every class, the weeklies, the miracle class, the freedom class, the weekend gatherings, to authorize the great activation of the great central sun's feeling of divine will to be upon each of you, to supersede your will that has been frozen into the duality consciousness of this world, and placing upon each of you a magnet's presence that pulls upon you and pulls upon you and lifts you and raises you through your resurrection and snaps the magnetic pull that the duality consciousness has upon you. For this great victory, there must be something else that happens first. I ask you to realize that in so many of the discourses that have come to you, many pieces have been given with a hopeful heart that each of you would be putting those pieces together and having ahas and insights and epiphanies. For example, it is not that long ago that we brought to your attention that in terms of the spiritual hierarchy, there is no being that directly represents your planet. Oh yes, there is a great goddess of Venus who represents her planet. There are the great Jupiter queens who oversee Jupiter. And there is the great divine director who oversees this entire system of worlds. But there is no goddess of Earth until that one whose destiny is to become this achieves that. And so you heard a few years ago, because of very important activities, even future activities that had not yet come into your awareness, that the Holy Mother, the Blessed Mary, had agreed to temporarily take on the assignment and the spiritual hierarchy as Goddess of Earth. Yes, I just give you this as one example of the many things that you have heard in the past that were pieces, preparations to ensure that what I am about to say to you tonight opens the way for the most historical change that you and the hundreds of embodiments that you have lived upon this earth begins to occur for each of you. Deep breath. And I hope I have built enough anticipation that you desire to hear what it is. And so it is, dear heart. I want you to go out in nature, even if it's only a couple minutes, and with as much heart authenticity, with as much generosity of your own heart, with as much love and understanding, I want you to talk to your planet. And this is what I would like you to say to her. My beloved planet, beloved Earth, I am aware that you have begun to shift your axis, that you so desire to shift yourself into a higher consciousness of light and love. My beloved planet, this is my message to you. I am willing to shift with you. It is so important. It is so important, dear hearts. It is monumental. It is part of the divine plan for the future. This is what she's waiting for. She's waiting for those who are awake, those who love God, love life, those who want to save this planet and humankind. She is waiting for you to give her loving recognition. She is waiting for you to say to her, I know these are not difficult. I know these are difficult times for you because of the discord we have planted upon your planet. And I know this discord is making it very difficult for you to shift your axis. My beloved planet, my beloved Earth, again I say to you, with all of my heart, I am willing to shift with you. Can you feel that, dear heart? And I just ask you, trust me, I have never let you down before. I have always told you the truth. This may indeed, in a very, very short period of time, bring about the awareness and a new experience and a shift in yourself where you will be able to say, never before has there been anything in my life that has created what I am now feeling. Towards the end of the Friday night in Calgary, as I shared this and I discoursed for almost 2 hours, the blessed hearts that had gathered there could feel themselves changing. They could feel a shift taking place because I paused in my discourse and I asked the blessed students to do that. by Saturday and late Saturday and into Sunday morning. The great joy, the change the students could experience, so tangible, so real, all the students reporting. In this weekend gathering, that they felt so different, so alive, so real, so tangible. Beloved Alexander, you were there. Do I speak the truth? Indeed. And so I say to you, dear hearts, in ways that the cosmic law does not yet permit me to speak at length, yet I say to you, this is a pivotal point in your resurrection. Yes, you've been Joseph in the beginning of his ministry, said to your beloved planet, I know that you wait to shift yourself. And I know that your people are not ready. And I will give you time. And we have not shared this before. I have waited for this class to say to you that in the place in India, where there is the ancient focus of light known to you as the Cave of Light, this too is a place in which ascended beings can enter in a secret passage into your earth and make their way into the center of the earth. One moment. May I have more? Thank you, that was water. You know, blessed hearts, it is not us. It's your own higher discerning intelligence that asks us to wait sometimes before certain information is revealed to you, so that that information will have an impact upon you at the perfect time. And so I say to you, those beings who oversee the Cave of Light in India, some 2,000 years ago, gave passage to the young rabbi known as Yeshu ben Joseph and gave him safe passage to the center of the earth. And it is there that Jesus had a message for your planet. It's not the same message that you are asked. But what he said, be patient, beloved daughter of great sons, for there are those who will come and who will carry the light of day and the Christ consciousness. Give them another 2,000 years. I will shift for you and give you that passage of time in which you can continue to exist in the present state of your axis. And the great being that is Gaia listened to the young rabbi. This was in the early days of his ministry. And yet she felt the great God presence and the authority in his heart. And indeed, she delayed shifting her axis. And indeed, his words have been fulfilled. There are those who are now on the surface of the planet. They are awake and embracing the greatest activity next to the ascension itself. And that is the resurrection. To make sure that your message to the planet, as authentic as you can make it, is one in which almost immediately, within minutes, there is a shift that begins to occur in yourself. A shift that is tangible and you can feel it, because this was authorized by the great being who oversees the powers of nature of any planet in this world, in this system of worlds, the Mahachohan. A number of pieces have come together. You have heard, dear hearts, that three of the elementals who were driven underground have surfaced, and now there are four. Now, in one of our beloved students, one of our pillars of the academy, there has been a fourth elf that has surfaced from Middle Earth in that area that is Kent of England in the United Kingdom. So the appearance of the elemental kingdoms, the coming to the surface, the angelics giving them protection, the Blessed Holy Mother Mary assuming a temporary position as the goddess of earth, the earth herself in her own wisdom choosing to embark on shifting her axis now rather than waiting until May 2012. The awakened ones around the world who have the knowledge of the sacred fire and all the calls and decrees they are making. The general opening of the heart of the mass of the people, even though they yet sleep under the tyranny of an old consciousness of God that is based on the hypnotic belief in good and evil. Even though that is occurring, yet the heart of the mass of the people is opening wonderfully. And so with all the collective efforts of awakened humankind, the elemental kingdoms, the angelic kingdoms, the ascended kingdoms, and your earth. And what about your earth in a way that you have never considered? What about her relationship with her sister planets? All planets have a relationship with each other. The outer world has been so demanding on the people that the people of Earth just never stop to think about these things. All planets that orbit around the sun's presence all have a relationship. And one of the great reasons that your planet Earth has been able to delay her own passage into a higher consciousness of light and love is the fact that Venus, Neptune, Jupiter all stepped in and have been cradling this planet with their love, the beings that live in the higher dimensions of those planets. And so now, dear hearts, well, I will not let go of you. And I would like to prepare you. I would still like you to go out in nature, go out for a walk tomorrow or tonight, and just be with a tree or in a grassy knoll. Yet let us do this together. All right? And so just take a moment and feel that you are in one of your favorite places in nature. Maybe it is a park. Maybe it is in your backyard. Just take a moment and transport your consciousness to a place where you feel that you are out in nature. And talk to your planet. My beloved Earth, long you have hosted humankind and given us the opportunity to embody upon your planet. giving us all that we require. Oxygen, fresh air, everything we require to come into these physical forms and evolve ourselves. I am so grateful. And now that I am awake, I understand that you have delayed your own evolution. You have delayed shifting your axis into a higher consciousness of light and love. I have heard that you are no longer delaying this, and that you have begun to shift your axis. My beloved planet Earth, I come to you with an authentic heart. Hear my message, my beloved planet. I am willing to shift with you. I am willing to make this shift with you. I am willing to shift with you. In the name of Mother, Father, God, I am. Deep breaths, beloved. And so, dear hearts, this will begin a whole new relationship between yourself and your planet. I have said to you before, every planet that hosts an intelligent species is equipped to give those ones everything they require. Your planet has an infinite system of energy. Energy to light and heat your homes. Energy to provide motion to your vehicles, trains, planes, boats. Your planet is waiting. She has learned because of what happened in the past, and the collapse of the land of Pan, and the collapse of the lands of Lemuria, and the collapse of the lands of Atlantis, and more recently, the tragic reinvention of hydrogen bombs. Your planet, in her own wisdom, has purposely delayed her secrets of energy. There is enough energy in this room that, when rightfully harnessed, could light up a city of 5 million for 3 years. And so, dear hearts, long has your planet not disclosed her energy to your scientists, because there are those yet on your planet that just become determined to misuse the constructive activities of life. I said to you tonight, my sharing was a new relationship with your planet Earth. What you've done here today, and all of you who are listening to me speak through the messenger's voice, you precious hearts around the planet, as each of you do this and give this message to your planet, it will initiate a new relationship between you and your planet, yourself and your planet. You will know things about your planet. In days and weeks and months, you will begin to know things about your planet that you didn't know before. She will begin to release into your life a sense of direction. She will help you in your affairs of personal and individual enlightenment. And she will help you to experience much greater happiness in your life. Your planet will help you shift as you say to her, I am willing to shift with you. This shift will be so noticeable, you will feel it physically, spiritually, mentally, and you will feel a force of divine presence from this planet. And she will begin a whole new relationship with you. And of course, what is going to grow within you is probably an intolerance to those who litter, to those who impose discord upon her. And all things will grow evenly and perfectly for you. I have a great gift in my return from the great central sun. I initiated the first for our beloved family in Calgary. I will initiate and activate again and again the gift. But right now, before you receive the magnetic current of the divine will of the great central sun upon each of you, it is important that you do this. Let this message go around the world. Use every means available. Let the word get out there. It's simple. Our beloved planet, we know you are shifting your axis. We know there is divine purpose. You have a destiny. And our message to you, those of us heart-driven, those of us who are awake, our message is, we are willing to shift with you. I thank you, dear hearts. It is time for your break, and our beloved son will open the way for Lord Kutumi to offer his love to you. I thank you. God bless you, and good night. We love and bless you, Mother Akasha. We are so grateful for your love, your presence, and your gifts. Deep breath, everyone.